Merc, what was that in the
nigga, you woke? Keep your eyes on the road, nigga. Pass the weed. We gonna head up Interstate 10. We gonna pick up Pimp C and Bum B.
That's my nigga.
We gonna get ride and body body. We gonna handle our business. We gonna smoke. We gonna make it back to the NO. Cause you know what? Us South niggas don't play. Hey, we got love from the South, the East, to the West, to the Nizzo. But it's your time now, baby. We gonna handle our business. And we gonna do this shit like G. We gon' represent to the Disney, you heard me?
This game fucked up, I ain't got no friends. And I done spent my last $70,000 on a drop top Benz. And I'm a trill nigga, trying to put the 45 to his heel figure. Lay it down, motherfucker, cause I'm busting for mine. Take that down every time, and I ain't trying dying. Niggas down in Port Arthur, still think that I'm playing. Bust 70 times to let them feel what I'm saying.
Talk to me, homeboy. What's going on with this stuff in the Ozone magazine, man? A-Town's kind of furious.
You tell me how you took it, I'm going to tell you what I meant.
Okay, let me tell you what the A-Town's saying. The A-Town's basically saying, you know, why you they think you dissing in Atlanta. Talking about Atlanta's not the South.
Okay, well, first of all, listen to this. I used to live in Atlanta from 96 till 2001, okay? All
right.
That's the first thing. The second thing is this. When I get off the airplane in Atlanta, what time is it?
It's whatever time it is out here, homie.
It's like, Eastern Standard Time.
But it's still on the south side of the map.
Okay, but it's Eastern Standard Time, ain't it?
On the south side of the map, yeah.
Answer my question. Is it Eastern Standard Time?
Yeah, it is on the south side of the map.
All right. Well, after saying that, listen to this. All my statements are my statements. That's how I feel. And feelings is like booty holes. Anybody can have their own feelings. That's my feelings. That ain't got nothing to do with Bun B. Okay, that's the first thing. So let's separate PFC statements from UGK and Bun B. That's the first thing we got to do.
All right, okay.
Next thing we got to do is this. You got some people over there that feel a certain way that I might not like how they feel. But that's how I feel. If you want to get mad at me for the way I feel, then go and get mad at me. And a fight go with that. You feel me?
But, Pimp C, why are you so mad? It just seemed like you real angry.
You know why I'm mad? Let me tell you why I'm mad. I'm mad because everybody on these records lying. Everybody lying. Everybody's this big D-boy. Everybody's these hardcore gangsters. Everybody gonna do this to each other when they see each other. And the truth be told, we too blessed and we having too much money in this rap game to be going to war with each other.
Right. Okay.
And the truth be told, don't nobody want to fight nobody in this rap game. Because 98% of these dudes is cowards.
You got any specific artists you referring that to?
I'm not dissing nobody, man. I'm just telling you that if we don't clean it up, we're going to lose everything we fought to get, man. Don't you see that the game is fit to lead us out and go somewhere else if we don't straighten up?
Yeah, we see that. Well, we know. I know what's going on.
If we don't clean out our own closet, who going to clean it for us?
All right, so what do you, by you saying that, what do you think needs to be done?
This is what I think needs to be done, man. Come on, man. At the end of these records we listen to, we don't get nothing out of them no more, man. We don't get no social commentary. We ain't getting no kind of knowledge out these records. Everybody just talking about how many chains they got on and how much dope they sold. But the truth of the matter is this, I don't believe you, because I know you do, and I know you didn't sell no dope. And the next thing is this. Say, man, I'm from Texas, man. I'm from the game. Them prices that them boys talking about, man, them boys ain't got no prices like that, no Atlanta. And if you do, right now, bring some where my people at, we'll buy it and flush it down the toilet. We don't support drugs. But show it to me, man, because I know where it on backpacks. I know where they passed they rolled up in Timberland boots in 1998, and they acting like they some big-time drug dealers. Okay?
Okay.
So right now, this is what I'm telling you. Y'all want to get mad at the pimp. Don't get mad at the Bun, and don't put the UGK on it. Get mad at the pimp. This is my opinion. This is me. I'm talking. I'm a man. And I stand up. And let me say this while I'm at it. All them people that was talking about they want to kill 50 Cent, want to do all that to this man. Hey, man, when somebody really wants something to happen to you, it's going to happen to you whether you want it to or not. And I just saw 50 Cent walk off the stage at the BET Awards with no bodyguards, right in front of all them dudes that were talking about they was going to slap him when they saw him. And I ain't seen nothing happen to him.
So basically, you just calling the game real fake, and you saying that the music need to go back to some real lyrics. And
it's the next thing, man. Anytime an artist in Atlanta makes crunk music and get on a record, they need to shout out to 3-6 Mafia, because y'all know that's where that music started at, man. But, and y'all know for a fact that UGK started the word trill. Y'all know this, man. Y'all know we started this here.
Everybody in Atlanta feels like you diss them. They feel this because
they would read between the lines and hear what I'm telling them. I ain't dissing them. We got to check ourselves before somebody else check us. Because this would have hurt a whole lot more coming from somebody on the East Coast or from the West Coast than coming from one of our forefathers down here.
But then what you saying that we're not even from the South, like Atlanta ain't the South, like, you know, it's a lot of UGK fans that got their feelings hurt today because they really love you.
Here's the truth of the matter. I love them too. But we got to straighten out the game. And if the statement was made in the wrong context, I apologize about that. But I meant what I was saying. Now, maybe it was heard the wrong kind of way. What I'm saying is this. Hey, man, when I get off the plane, I got to change my watch. Because I live in Texas, and I'm on Central Time.
Okay.
All right?
That's Central.
So that's my opinion. I can have my opinion.
Yeah,
you might
can.
Not like my opinion. But that's my opinion.
All right, so everybody running around, they're basically telling Jeezy, because the magazine hasn't hit the stands, that you were pointing him out with the 17-5.
And the Meech talk.
The what?
It says the magazine's making it seem like you're pointing out Jeezy with the 17-5 talk, and it has something here about Meech.
And everybody's blowing up Jeezy phone saying that, you know, basically that it's about to be some beef between you and him. So, that's just the talk in Atlanta.
And the Russell Simmons.
Let me say this. There's a whole bunch of people lying. So if you want to point fingers at somebody, let's point fingers at everybody. If I was going to diss Young Jeezy, I would have came right out and said his name and dissed him. I'm not scared of no man. And the next thing is this. They need to free Big Meech because it's all circumstantial evidence. And the next thing is this. Everybody was down and everything was cool with BMF before they got busted. Everybody wanted to be down with the play until they got busted. And then when it went sour, then nobody want to fly the flag no more. Am I lying or telling the truth?
I think it's because they ain't want to go to jail, though.
Yeah, but they was down when the party was going on and everybody was throwing money in the club. Everybody was still down. So you got to be down in the good time and the bad time. When I went to prison, Bun stayed down with me in the bad time. So when your partner go to prison, you got to stay down in the bad time and the good time. If you was Black Mafia family in the streets when they was spending all that money in the strip club, you need to be Black Mafia family right now when everybody getting indicted. And let me say it again. If I was going to diss somebody, I'm going to say their name to their face and a fight go with that. So now, I ain't diss Young Jeezy. Because Young Jeezy ain't the only one spitting fake dope prices. I'm dissing everybody lying about selling drugs. It ain't touched a nail drug.
All right, what's up with the Russell Simmons comment?
What about it?
I mean, it's basically saying that you saying that he's a
Okay.
That's kind of self-explanatory.
Right, it is.
But
okay.
But Pimp, Mr. Pimp C, basically, do you think, all right, you know, Bun held it down. There were a lot of, you know, quote-unquote fake rappers supporting the UGK movement while you were locked away. Do you think that your comments are going to ruin some of the relationships that Bun B made since you guys are a group and they look at you as a group?
If these is real people, they won't let my statements affect their relationships with Bun.
Okay.
But I got a lot of relationships with a lot of people I don't respect, I don't like, I don't want to work with them. When I get ready to do my album and I'm calling you and calling you and calling you and you don't call me back, and that means you're not down with helping me get my thing together. But when it's time to do your album, you call me and I had a record back within 24 hours, that means I'm being a real what?
Nigga.
Exactly. So now, guess what? If you want to charge Bun B $50,000 for a verse and then try to come back to me and pay me $1 to get me on your album, guess what you are? You fake and you garbage. If you was a cartoon character on your first album, then you need to be a cartoon character on your last.
Wow.
Now, let me say this. That's why I'm calling in, to let it be known the things I say don't need to reflect on my brother. He can have a relationship with them dudes all he wants to. Because truth of the matter is, if you fake and you abroad and we go to a club somewhere and somebody jump on me, you ain't going to help me fight no way.
Yeah.
You're going to run. So I don't need to be friends with you. And the next thing is this. If I ain't never had a personal phone number on you, I got to call your personal assistant to get to you. No flash. You ain't my friend in the first place.
Respect.
I'm down with Outkast, the Goody Mob, the whole Dungeon family. I'm down with Jazzy Faye. You know what I'm saying? I'm down with Lil Jon. I'm down with people that get back in touch with me after I call them, man. And if I'm calling you to do some work, and you don't get back with me, then you a broad. All you got to do is call me and tell me you don't want to get on the record with me, and that's cool.
Right.
Hey, Pimp, what up with, you know, the new rappers? They may start to say, well, I have heard people say that you mad because of the new generation is on a whole new movement. What do you have to say about that?
Who are the new rappers?
I guess like there's a T.I. and a Jeezy and all the one-hit wonders I hear.
Yeah, there's a
they
lot.
They would say because
you think T.I. is a one-hit wonder?
No. We talking about like the
new artists.
You see how it works?
Yeah.
Now you see how your words can get mixed up? Now you see how somebody can write something and then people take it the wrong way? Now do you see that?
Yeah.
Okay, now let's back up. Now, the new rappers, who are they?
Since you were away and came out, there's T.I., there's Jeezy, there's, Flip, and who else? Tell me next for their rappers.
I mean, the list goes on,
but they're saying that, you know, since you were a part of the old game, that you don't respect the newer rappers on the scene.
I could have swore I was on T.I.'s album explaining what the King of the South was, wasn't I?
Yeah, I
just did a song with Young Jeezy called a Dickie song that didn't come out. And every time he called me to do something, I did it for free and never charged him no money. I could have swore that after Crime Mob took my freestyle off the Lil Chick's mixtape and put it on their album, I didn't even sue him or do nothing to him. I could have swore that every time I get in an interview, I'm taking up for these dudes when it's some New York dudes or some L.A. dudes trying to diss them. I mean, show me one place where I talk down on Young Jock. Show me one place where I talk down on these dudes in a way to say that they not supposed to be in this game, they not supposed to be getting money. My thing is this. I want us to continue getting money for the next 15 years instead of falling off and letting it go back to the west or to the east because we're not putting no social commentary into the records.
That's
and the truth
up.
Be told is, look, hey, man, if you started being a gangbanger after your first or your second album, you a buster. And these kids out here listening to us and looking up to us because a lot of them don't have no father figure in their house. And every record you get on, you lying about some dope, talking about some squares. Man, guess what, man? Get off the boo-boo. Get off of it, man. Because if you're going to talk about some squares and talk about the drug game, you need to talk about the bad side of the drug game, too. What about when you get busted and you go to jail? What about when your mama and your wife and your kid is crying because they at home and you in prison in a cell? What about that part of the dope game? Everybody talking about how many cars and how many jewels they going to buy and how many squares coming off. You know what I'm talking about? But ain't nobody talking about the other side of it. So if you're going to talk about that, you got to talk about both sides. And I'm going to say it again. If you a cartoon character on your first album, you need to be a cartoon character on your last. Because the way we start is the way we going to finish.
Can't do nothing to respect that, homie.
You go back to that Ozone article, and you read every statement I made in there. And if you find a place in there where I lied about somebody, you research it. Y'all give me a call back, and I clarify what I meant.
There it is,
Pimp.
Now, guess what? Now, let me say this, and I want it to be clear. I'm not apologizing for what I said. I'm clarifying what I meant by what I said.
Correct. Okay.
We all know Atlanta, the South, we got to start acting like it's the South. And we got to start having some pride like it's the South. And let me say this, and y'all might not like this, because a lot of people don't like stuff. But ATL is considered to be the gay capital of the world right now. And y'all got clubs over there with boys standing in the parking lot kissing on the mouth. And, you know, if you're gay and you're out of the closet, that's cool because everybody got their preference. But, man, it's time to start cleaning up our own neighborhood because a dude from Texas shouldn't have to get on in no magazine to make you clean up your neighborhood. So if I really wanted to diss Atlanta, it was a bunch of things I could have said about a bunch of people, and I could have really, really dissed and hurt some feelings. Now, don't you know that?
Yes, sir.
Because I know who the gay rappers is. I know who let them models stick them dildos in them, and I know who did what, where, when, and why.
Wow.
So now, do you feel like expressing that right now?
Yeah,
you know?
Say this again.
If you feel like saying it, go ahead.
Say this again. I'm proud of all the rappers in the South. I'm proud of everybody selling records in Atlanta. But everybody ain't my friend, and I don't like all y'all records. Now, if you want to diss me and get on with me, go on and do it. But in between me and them other dudes is this. You're going to diss me, and I'm going to come see you, Jack. You're going to diss them other dudes, and they're going to play lip wrestle with you. So if you want it, man, come on with it. If you want it with me, come on with it. Leave Bun out of it, and we're going to see in the end, because you're going to smell my cologne, Issey Miyake, on some Bun number 9, because I do not play.
That's the same cologne I wear.
Tabernacle Sanctuary, because we keep God first in everything we do.
Hey, Pimp.
Yes, sir.
Do you mind expressing any of those rappers you was talking about?
Them sugar sausages?
Oh, man.
I want to know them.
Them gay rappers you know about?
Nah, man, it's no need to embarrass nobody that ain't done nothing to us. Yeah.
Respect.
But if you gay, man, and you ashamed of it, you need to stop doing stuff you're ashamed of. Anything done in the dark gonna come to the light. I ain't gotta expose them, because they exposing themselves every day and every night.
They sure are.
But see, you work at a radio station, and it's your job to ask me that question, and me being a real person is my job to know how to answer it, ain't it?
You already
what's
know.
Up?
All right,
Pat. Okay, so if you gay and you rap, And you staying in the closet, then you need to come on out of the closet and let us know who you is. Because if you ain't proud of what you do, then don't do it. And if anything you're ashamed of, you shouldn't be doing it. You know who's getting caught in the Range Rover with the bar? You know what's going on in that lounge, just like I know. You know who got caught in the Range Rover with the bar? Okay?
Nah, I don't, really.
Okay, you nice, know, you crazy.
Know. Because oh, yeah. If I know you know, because you in Atlanta.
Oh, wow. I know what you're talking about.
So let me say this. All the real street people in Atlanta and all the hardcore UGK fans, I hope I have clarified what I meant by that statement.
All right, that's
anybody
all.
Anybody else that don't like me or still want to hate on me, come on with it.
I think all
I
in
you don't want it with me.
I think in all, your fans in Atlanta just still want to know that you love them. That's all.
Hey, man, guess what? I used to live in Atlanta. If I wasn't on parole, I would still live in Atlanta, and I still would have made them statements. And I'm coming back to Atlanta as soon as somebody booked me a ticket to come there and do a show.
We tried to get you to come last night.
I had a blowout in the rain and had to change the tire myself.
Oh, damn.
If you have a blowout and you got both your kids in the back seat and your wife driving, is you going to jump in another car and leave them on the side of the road to go catch an airplane?
Hell no.
I didn't think you would. So you know what? When that rain was coming down and we had that blowout in that Lexus and both my babies was in the back seat, I had to get out there and change that myself.
Right.
Because I didn't have time to call nobody else to do it. And I was not going to leave my family on the side of the road. And anybody don't like that can eat 7,000 wee-wees and die.
There it is.
So if you don't like that and you don't understand that, then you don't have no understanding about life. And anybody that puts this rap game or their job or anything up here to their family or God, well, you know what? Shame on you.
No,
and guess what?
Not.
Part 2 of my article is coming out next month in Ozone. So get ready to get your jaws tight again.
Can we expect to hear from you again next month, issue?
You can hear from me anytime you want to. But let me tell you this, man. We need to stop with the boo-boo, man. We need to stop promoting negative things.
Yeah.
UGK was started out talking about drugs and things. But now we on the records talking about the other side of the drugs and what happens when you get off into negative things. We need to stop promoting the wrong thing.
That's definitely somebody got to step up and make it happen.
Somebody got to do it. And guess what? You think anybody that did it, they was going to like it when they heard? Don't nobody like medicine. It don't taste good. They just want a whole bunch of the same old everybody licking each other booty and being cowards. Well, guess what? I'm taking a stance against the cowards. I'm taking a stance against the lies. And I'm telling you, we need to stop doing all this old negative stuff.